Hello everyone, welcome back to English Learning Session with me, Mr. Adi. Today I would like to explain a little bit more about this material about present perfect and already and yet, because I think some of you still confused or didn't understand this material well. So this dimension to this explanation. Well, present perfect and already and yet. The first one, always remember that we use already only on the positive sentence. Yeah. We use already on the positive sentence. And then we use yet in the negative sentence. And then the formula like I already explained last meeting, there is subject plus has or have plus already plus verb 3 or the past participle and then the complement. Yeah? Okay, okay. Subject plus has or have plus already plus verb 3 plus the complement or the rest of the sentence. Well, the subject here can be I, you, they, we, he, she, it, or the other things. Yeah? So, take it for example here. Now, for has or have, it depends on the subject. If the subject are I, you, they, we, then we use have. If the subject is like he, she, it, so we use has. Do you understand? Well, take a look for example here. If there is a question like the exercise today, like I, blah, 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 it means the positive, so you must use the positive sentence already. And then this is the verb one. Yeah, it is the verb one or the verb base. So you must change this verb into verb 3 or past participle. And then this is the object. Yeah, or the rest of the sentence. So let's make it into complete sentence. The subject is I, okay, and then the auxiliary we use has or have. Right, we use have. Don't forget to put already. Already, and then now this verb you must change into the verb 3 or the past participle. What is the verb 3 of see? See, saw, seen. Yeah. Already seen. Yeah. From to see become seen. I have already seen the movie. Great. So this is the complete sentence. I have already seen the movie. Okay. Is it clear? How about if I change the subject? For example, I change the subject into Tom. Tom, do you use have for Tom? No, of course not. We use has. I'm sorry, we use has. Because Tom, we can change into he. Right? Tom has already seen the movie. Nice. Do you understand? Thank you. Well, the next one, this is the example of the negative sentence. Forget. Yeah? Remember, the formula is subject, has or have, plus not, because it is negative sentence. And then the verb 3, the complement, and the last one is yet. Remember, put the word yet at the end of the sentence. Okay. This example, we have the subject is she, and then the form is negative, so we use yet. And then the verb base or the basic verb is to go. Then to Paris. So how do we make it to the complete sentence? You write she What is that? Go where? Gone. Good. She has now gone to Paris. Yeah. Is it clear? She has not gone to Paris yet. Okay. Okay. She has not gone to Paris yet. Don't forget to put yet at the end of the sentence. Well, this example. Okay. How if we change the subject into they, for example? They. Julius has, no, of course not, Julius have not gone to Paris yet. Well, is it clear? Well, I think it's not really difficult grammar, so I hope that you can master it well. Because I've already explained here and I've already given you some examples here. And now, please do the exercise in the Google form and don't forget to write the complete form. Yeah. I mean, you don't need to write present or please write a complete sentence like this. Yeah. Okay, so I think that's all for the explanation for this material today. Thank you for your attention and have a nice day.